Today I'm on the corner of Walcott and Barrie, and it's important to note that we're on a corner lot because you'll see when we go inside that they did some unusual things with the floor plan that they were only able to do because they're on the corner. They moved the front of the house down the side here, and that made some of the things they wanted to do inside possible. But before we go in, the other thing to notice is these French doors that run down the side and also are on the front of the house. The designer who lives here, Tracy Hickman, the seller of the house, one of the sellers, said that she was going for sort of a modern Parisian look. She wanted the idea that the inside and outside sort of flowed together. You could get the breezes, that sort of thing. And all these doors, which we'll see again inside, accomplished that. So let's go in and see what else she did. This is Jamie Connor, the agent who's selling the house. Thank you. Thanks for having me in, Jamie.
Dennis, thanks
How
for
are
coming.
You?
Good, thank you.
One of the things I noticed when we came in is something that your seller, Tracy, described to me. We come right to the living room and actually feel like using it because the front door has been pushed down around the side of the house. So what we're not going to do is come in the front door and have to sort of parade all the way through the house to the kitchen or wherever people are going to gather.
Yeah, that's actually one of the big things that the owner and the architect, Chuck Cook, had in mind when they were designing the home. They wanted to take advantage of the 34-foot wide lot so that they could actually make this front room into a very livable, comfortable space and encompass the 1,000 square foot terrace off of the front as well.
And then from here, we pass down through the hall that I came through, but then let's go into the kitchen and dining room, talk about those.
Sure. That space they actually designed and they built it so it was a kitchen-dining combination. So the home is really designed for comfortable living. And they've got beautiful inlays with glass, with rice paper pressed between the two, which you can, with lighting behind it, which actually just really kind
of it's really sharp. It. It's very sharp. And that sort of looks directly across to the kitchen and dining really are one together unit, which is nice. We're not going from a formal closed off kitchen into another box, a dining room, which Tracy said was important to her.
Yeah, and again, I think that you'll see throughout this home, it's all about living. It's all about living and living comfortably. And what you'll see, again, the transition from the kitchen dining space into the living area, you'll see a kind of our second round space on this level. And they've got beautiful imported limestone slabs throughout that kind of then transitions into a little bar area with a dual sub-zero refrigerators, an ice maker, and then goes down a couple of steps into a stunning living space with another fireplace.
It's in that little black box.
Really large, generous living area, built-in TV, speaker systems throughout that then will lead to the outdoor space.
Well, that's terrific. You know, you mentioned earlier the little bar on this floor. When we go downstairs, there's a big bar, and I mean a big bar.
Yeah, we've got a stunning mahogany bar downstairs with a professional bar or beer and beverage refrigerator. Beautiful limestone countertops. It's really quite impressive, and that leads right into the pool table area.
Another bedroom down there, an office, and what interested me the first time I walked down there is the color of the walls is essentially this color we're in, which struck me as an unusual choice for a basement room, for a below ground room. It's got the clear story windows at ground level, and I talked to Tracy about it, and she said, you know, it's got a great mood.
The way that she has the lighting, most of her lighting in the home is all designer, and she literally picked out piece by piece, and it plays off really, really well with the paint colors that she's chosen, and it makes it feel really comfortable when you're down there.
Well, I know she picked some really good light fixtures, but she also took good advantage of sunlight. We should go take a look at this commercial grade skylight. Well, as promised, we got to a very sunny space here under this skylight. This is terrific, and it pulls the light all the way down, we saw, into the basement.
Yeah, the entire home really takes advantage of this really large skylight. It's about 40 square feet, 10 by 4.
Yeah.
And it really, you know, there's no lights on in this home right now at all, and it's really quite bright.
Yeah, it feels good. One of the rooms up here we should mention first is the laundry room because it's got a view.
The laundry room has a southwest corner exposure, so it's fabulous sunlight all day long. It's built in with imported limestone slab countertops and waterworks fixtures, so it really is really a beautiful space.
In the master, we've got sort of a nice separation from these other rooms. You actually have to go there to be in it. But then there's a different kind of separation when we get into the bathroom. I was so surprised. Not only are there two toilet rooms, two vanities, which often people have, but there are two separate showers.
This is truly a his and hers master suite. You've got two separate commode rooms, two separate showers, and they're kind of met in the middle with a Waterworks two-person soaking tub. The flooring in that bathroom has three different heat zones, so depending on where everyone's comfort levels lie, they can control with his and hers walk-in closets kind of winging the bathroom on both sides.
one of the advantages of this lot is mature trees surrounding a new house so that it doesn't feel as if we've got these spindly little things that the alderman forced us to plant, right? We actually have the shade, the beautiful greenery surrounding the house.
Without a doubt. That was actually one of the things that really attracted Tracy and Chad to the lot was the fact that it's on a corner and it's in a mature neighborhood. So they really were able to take advantage of the outside. There's great windows, great light throughout the home, and they've really kind of done a nice job to bring that inside.